All right, YouTubers, HatrickPenry here, and first thing this morning I see is an article titled Chinese Solar Producer Suntech Declares Bankruptcy. It's got a picture down here, you can't really see it very well, but it's Al Gore. It says in this Friday, June 11, 2010 file photo, former U.S. Vice President Al Gore Center visits Suntech, a solar cell factory in Wuxi near Shanghai, China. Suntech, one of the world's biggest solar panel manufacturers, said Monday it had defaulted on a $541 million bond payment in the latest sign of the financial squeeze on the struggling global solar industry. Now, what I want to point out right now, for me, as far as I am concerned, globally, I think the large powers are all in cahoots together. I know they put on a great act when Putin sits next to Obama and Alex Jones mentions it and ABC News mentions how angry Putin is and all. And that's just an act. Again, this is a very clever act. And the same act goes with China and as our adversaries and Russia as our adversaries. Neither of these are really our real adversaries. We're all working together to pull the wool globally over everybody's head so they don't know what the truth of the matter is. The energy is darn near nearly free. Tesla knew that. We all know that now. It's coming out now. When you look at Suntech and you look at Solyndra, two of these failed companies, you can clearly see that if we're going to restrict patents in regards to solar technology, for instance, the Union of Concerned Scientists has made a statement, there's 5,000 plus patents back in 2010 that were suppressed, and if you had a solar cell that was more than 20% efficient, well, they could seize upon it and restrict it. So, sorry about that. When the cat's in the litter box, is scratching around, he's making a symphony. It sounds like a symphony of scratching going on, right? I'm trying to save the world, Alola, if you don't mind. Okay, anyway, so what I wanted to be very clear on is around the world, Iran is as guilty as China, Russia is as guilty as Iran, United States is as guilty as all of them. What is going on? The name of the game is technology suppression. Through information suppression, which results in an energy monopoly. And that's how the whole world is controlled. If you go back to Bill Cooper's book, Behold a Pale Horse, he does talk extensively about information and energy, right? And that, I'm telling you, I'm copying a lot of what he said. So clearly we look here at China, we look at Suntech, we look at America, we look at Solyndra, we look at patent suppression, specifically solar technology, and clearly right now, we are being forced to use certain archaic, outdated, dangerous, polluting technologies. Meanwhile, businesses are failing, jobs are failing, because these guys are incredibly greedy. And I'll finish up by giving you a little analogy that I tell my wife and I tell my mom. In the book Where the Red Fern Grows, where the kid buys his two hound dogs and he hunts the raccoons and everything, in there they tell you the story of down in the hollows in the river bottoms when you don't have dogs to actually hunt the coons, one of the common tricks is to find an old stump and drive nails all the way around it down into the stump. So you have like a 1-inch hole where the nails meet inside the stump. In bottom of that, you drop a silver coin or a shiny piece of tin. And what happens is the raccoon, as he makes his rounds down in the river bottoms, he comes to this stump and he looks inside and sees the shiny coin. They cannot resist the shiny coin. So they put their hands in through that little hole with the nails driven downward, and he wraps his hand around the coin. Now his hand is bigger than it was when it went in there. So when the raccoon goes to retract his paw, he cannot pull it out because of the nails driven down in that tiny hole. His fist is now larger than the hole when it went in because he's clutching the coin. Well, according to the book, they won't let go of that coin. You can walk right up on them and club them to death, and that's what they do if you don't have hound dogs. That's how you get your coon skins. So you can walk right up on them, and rather than let go of that shiny coin, the raccoon will sit there trying to pull his hand out and let you get close enough and club him to death. And that's my point, what's going on around the world with the rich people of planet Earth. Right now they could just let go of that shiny coin and we could all get along a lot better, right? But they're clutching on that shiny coin and they're going to take us all down with them when they go. So I just want to end on that because I don't believe that China and Russia and the United States are at odds. I think we're all working together on a giant global energy monopoly. It can only be so when Al Gore is in front of Suntech and it fails just like Solyndra. You see, they're designed to fail. Someone makes a lot of money when each one of these businesses fail. Make no mistake. Okay, that's it for today, folks. Don't fall for this energy monopoly. and this scam of a patent suppression, and they try to convince you there all are no alternative energies. The pizza guy that delivered my pizza yesterday, I mentioned Stan Meyer's water car to him, and yes, he had heard of it, and he said anything that's more environmentally friendly as well. So the learning curve is happening. We're starting to figure it out. The question is, how much longer can they maintain this monopoly? Because as soon as the energy monopoly on planet Earth is broken, and this is no one's going to disagree with me on this, but everything changes. The game completely changes down to your smallest, tiniest guy at the very bottom of the totem pole. Things change radically, and we all become equals on this planet. And that's the way I see it. Okay, HatrickPenry, have a good day. Over and out.